Do you ever look at someone and wonder what is going on inside their head?
New Put a Finger Down Challenge System Edition. Blind react, don't blind react if you want. It's completely up to you. All right, now put 10 fingers down if, even though you love your system and you love the ultras in your system, you would get rid of this disorder at the first chance you get.
All right, here's a little extra context for anyone who thinks that we just said no because we're overly attached to our disorder or something. We were given DID when we were 3 years old. We've been changing hosts every like 4 years since the body was six. We have no us before the DID memories besides like being a baby playing with baby toys. So essentially us without the DID would be some random singlet that we have no idea who it would be. So we would rather not cease our existence and become a stranger of a singlet. I don't think that's a path for us. And like, this isn't about Final Fusion. This is about like getting rid of the disorder theoretically. I'm not saying anything about Final Fusion. Healing from DID and theoretically getting rid of DID are two totally different things.
Fuck off! Yak, yak, fucking yak!
Oh, Jesus Christ!
LTGBEIEIO.
Who's been eating my porridge?
How the hell did I end up in Canada? Hey. I hate fucking Canada!
You're all looking at me like I'm fucking up, which I am!
Oh my god, guys, we just realized something. We've had therapy off and on since we were about 11 years old. We got our diagnosis of DID when we were 19. So technically, we did spend about 7 years in the medical industry before getting our DID diagnosis. Although I literally don't see how that determines our validity as having a mental illness. I'd really like for us to stop normalizing getting several bad, uneducated therapists in a row who don't know what they're talking about and misdiagnose people before they actually get the real diagnosis. That shouldn't be the normality. When we got a therapist who was willing to listen and actually do research and give us the screening tests, it took about 6 months to get a diagnosis. And that was with us going in, being like, let's not hide the DID and everything. So looking back on it, yeah, we spent like 7 years in the medical industry before our diagnosis, but that shouldn't be the normality.
This is weed, pot, cannabis, Mary Jane. Ain't nothing cool about what it can do to your brain. It messes with your memory.
You.
And when it comes to solving problems,
what do I do?
It can affect your focus.
What?
Your coordination too. Oh, smoking weed can hurt your lungs, shrink your eyes.
On time is tricky. It's tricky, 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 tricky. It's tricky to rock around, to rock around. That's right, on time is tricky. Tricky, tricky, tricky. I met this little.
I'd probably say both yes and no for this one. So yeah, alters can't like die like regular people can because they're part of your brain and parts of your brain can't die. So they can be dead alters where the alter themselves believes that they are dead or that could be part of their system role in order to like survive trauma. You'll see quite a few dead alters or ghost alters around. They're actually not impossible to happen. Then on the note of alters disappearing forever, that's somewhat of a possibility. Like they can't completely leave your system really. They kind of would go dormant or into a place of the system where no one else could really see them. That's happened a few times with us. Alters could also split off more alters, fragmenting themselves further, hence dying in a way. So yes, alters can die, but not in the way that normal people die. Yeah, generally we can tell before the fusions are going to happen. We kind of get like a feeling, or the alters kind of get closer to each other in the inner world, and then kind of, for lack of better phrasing. And that process can take anywhere from like 5 minutes to an ongoing thing. Like, it could almost be instantaneous. Like, Phoenix took like 45 seconds. Ballista took a couple minutes, but Dorian took like 3 months to solidify, so it can definitely vary by alters in the system. And sometimes it takes a while for the fusion to actually take and the alters to like stay together in one form. Sometimes they'll kind of come apart and go back together a few times before it stays, but that's kind of just how integrations, fusions go sometimes.
Emotions all attacking me, I don't want the answer, but how long this been happening? Deep down, see the sea ground, I'm getting close, I don't wanna sit and watch.
Get out of my sandwich. No.
I just gotta pop in and say a thing. So before anyone gets this cemented into their minds, there is not a maximum amount of alters that you can have if you have DID or OSDD. There's literally a lady in a documentary who passed law school and she has 2,500 alters. Look it up on YouTube. We've seen a lot of stigma around systems with more than like 30 members, which is actually very common in our experiences. The diagnostic criteria is two or more identities. There's not a limit. Something that people don't talk about with DID. I have to go and meet my coworkers all over again today. This is the millionth time I've had to do this. It is not fun anymore. It is not fun to pretend to be some dude named Devin who doesn't exist anymore and have a facade of that and try to maintain that across 200 something alters. That's not easy. That was our attempt to try to not have DID and be normal as we can at work. We feel like we're living a lie. I'm not gonna be able to mask easily. I'm gonna have to tell one of my bosses. Luckily, they're all cool and some of them already know, so it's not too big of a deal. I just wanna look good for you, uh-huh. Let me show you how proud I am to be yours. Even it's just a mess on the floor. I still look good. Downside of DID, constant migraines. upset at DID, getting to go home early because of said migraines. This is definitely a difficult one to answer because there isn't really a one-size-fits-all for this one. Generally, what we do is kind of evaluate the situations and see the possible pros and cons of potential outcomes and kind of just go from there. Usually, the options that make all alters feel heard and validated are the ones that work the best. And sometimes you have to take really unconventional routes to do things, but that's kind of how it goes sometimes. So yeah, if they're the kind of alters that have outbursts, kind of find a way for them to channel their energy into something until they can chill out for a little bit, and then usually they're down to kind of talk more reasonably. So yeah, pretty much just being really opening to listening and understanding that some forms of communication may come across as violence, but it's just their way of trying to communicate. So our little ended up being the one who was fronting when we went grocery shopping this time. You think that would have been a bad idea. You think this would have ended in disaster, right? She wiped the floor with us with her grocery skills. She bought enough food for meals for at least a week, and she stayed, like, seriously under the budget. We had $68. She spent $53. And we have dietary restrictions, and 90% of this is completely fine with those. Like, I'm genuinely impressed by this. Littles in DID systems aren't necessarily just helpless children. They can do a lot of things. And people shouldn't be ashamed of having child alters.
Every Milligan case is a one in a million.
It was undisputed he committed the crimes. The question is whether he was innocent by reason of insanity.
Billy was not typical.
Multiple personality disorder is difficult to understand.
They would put Billy in a trance, and when he came out of the trance, he was a different personality.
Just every time I wake up, somebody says I did something bad.
Have you ever seen someone change personalities right in front of your eyes? Police in Columbus arrested Milligan.
Billy Milligan.
It still bugs me when they call me Billy, but I don't say much. I don't say anything, really. But I'm not Billy. Just every time I wake up, somebody says I did something bad.
You know what? Screw this. Most of the time when we come to, it's people thanking us at work for things that we've done but having no idea what we just did. It's alters doing things that the other alters couldn't. Not just going out and committing crimes. I have more people being like, "Hey bro, how you doing? It's great to see you," rather than, "Oh my god, you did a crime. Who are you now?" This documentary is not a good representation of real life cases of DID, and now we're just gonna have to prove that even more. So to start this out, yes, we do have weird opinions. At first, when this whole endogenic thing was going on, we were like, I think there should be more information about this. Where's the more research about this before we can actually, you know, say a statement without putting our foot completely in our mouth? And then, like, we took a step back from social media for a while and then came back and looked around and we were like, Jesus Christ, the animosity on both ends is very surprising. The amount of aggression that we've been seeing on this topic from both sides is just flat out alarming at this point. We don't even care at this point. If they turn out to be real, cool. If not, whatever. But the amount of aggression we've been seeing from person to person is just not cool. This is people's mental health that we're talking about, not political views.
Paranoia check, the people drive through bank. I took gas and go, took your bitch car. They should be Popeyes and Skittles. Go my beast mode. What's in your cup? Dirty Dan, dirty cup. Go drink it up. Now we motherfuckers stuck. You think you hot shit? Ain't no skill, that shit with luck. Got the dope from the beat and I stay with the bucks. Don't take no bills, cash coming bills. Hill shot like hills, wrist wet like bills. Wrist nice like milk, got balls wholesale. Low key can't tell, got sinos like a deal. My head. lavish, took some pictures, got them in the media. I've been get the fuck up on my back of your pockets, making me laugh. Turn the black to ash, time I wear the cash. Six be whipping, I went dipping when I hit the gas. You said you dripping fresh, but I don't see no splash. You see the pockets, they be fat, ain't no wind in there.
So integration versus fusion is definitely something that needs more defining. Integration is mostly the breaking down of amnesic barriers and sharing of memories so that communication between alters can happen pretty much seamlessly or much easier than it was before. And that wasn't a clarification that we got up until a few years ago. Like, for a while there, integration and infusion were used basically interchangeably. Fusion is that occurrence when multiple alters become one alter. And are they fuse together. Personally, we don't like the word fusion because of just our personal system history. So that's why you'd catch us using integration instead of fusion in some occasions. Though admittedly, that's more of an old habit than anything. So yeah, integration is the breaking down of amnesic barriers for better communication. Fusion is multiple alters becoming one alter.
A common misconception about hosts in DID or OSDD systems is that they're the core essence or the one who was born into the body. Sometimes that's the case, but that's definitely not always the case. Most often, the host is the one who fronts the most, is in the control of the body the most often. So depending on who's out more, I'd say the one who fronts the most often is most likely the host.
And you can also have multiple hosts. There isn't always a just one host rule. Like, we have, I think, four. And hosts can also change over time, so if someone is the host now, that may not mean that they're going to be the host forever.
Admittedly, not as well as we'd like. Although we got lucky enough to have compulsive hygiene rituals which keep us showered every day and makes us brush our teeth once in the morning and once before bed. But admittedly, we're really bad at keeping the body fed. We've got what the gastroenterologist calls non-ulcerative dyspepsia, so most of the things that we eat cause us to be in serious physical pain. Which really doesn't help considering that most of the alters in the system already have an aversion to normal food. So usually we can tell if the body hasn't eaten judging by like how hungry the body is or how acidic our insides feel. So we generally go off of how the body feels because we usually have a pretty good sense on whether or not people have done the things.
Why people are so reluctant to actually believe that other people have DID. Like, what are y'all gonna do if they recount the population statistics or whatever and it turns out to be like 0.06 of the population? What are you gonna do then? Because the current statistics are the cases that are diagnosed yearly, not counting the ones that have been diagnosed before that year. Unlikely does not mean impossible. Rare does not mean impossible. People with DID exist.
Thank you.
I have a question for systems. If you have to go to the ER or urgent care or something, do you tell them that you are a system? Or if another system mate fronts, do they just mask as the host? I feel like it's a really difficult situation to be in, and I'm just curious how other systems handle it.
Put a finger down challenge, but I'm not telling you what it is until the end. Put a finger down if your parents are separated. Put a finger down if you're closer to one parent than the other. Put a finger down if you have a mental illness or an eating disorder. Put a finger down if being told you look like one of your parents is considered an insult. Put a finger down if you will or already have moved out of your parents' house at the earliest opportunity. Put a finger down if you have a dark and twisted sense of humor. Put a finger down if you love crime documentaries and/or serial killers. Put a finger down if you have been described as rebellious. Put a finger down if you have been told you're more mature than most people your age. Put a finger down if you have a wide variety of music tastes. Put a finger down if you have cold feet about maintaining healthy relationships. Put a finger down if you open up easily to others. If you put six or more fingers down, how are your abandonment issues, sweetie?
Hey, what's up, y'all? I just wanted to give a shout out to my fellow systems. This is the week when that Billy Milligan limited docu-series is coming out. And I know that can be really stressful and honestly kind of scary, because that's some pretty not good representation of people with dissociative disorders. But we got through Split, and we'll get through this too. There will be better representation of DID eventually. And yes, it really does feel like it falls on the DID community to pick up the scraps from this awful representation. But we can do it. Now more than ever is a time to stand together with your fellow systems instead of infighting about silly things, and try to promote good word about dissociative disorders. But in the meantime, we can get through this together.